death by calcium. Death by calcium. Your water heater does not want to die. They're expensive. They're over $2,000, basically. You don't want it to die either, do you? So how do we prevent death by calcium? So first of all, calcium is rock that's attached to the water droplet. And as you can see, we actually cut open a water heater here to help show you some of this. We're actually going to show you an image of what it sort of looks like. Rock basically is attached to the water droplet. Now, when that comes in through the water heater, basically there's an in and out. And as it falls through here, we're heating that water with flame. And that's on the bottom of this water heater here, right? So we got gas that's actually flames or an electrical coil that's on the inside of the water heater. And what they're doing is they're flaming the steel. And then from there, the steel heats the water. But the minute that we run water through here with rock, it pops off the water droplet, falls to the steel, and starts building a layer of rock like a brick on the bottom of that water heater. Well, guess what happens? We have the flame heating the steel and then the rock. So it becomes very inefficient. And before long, you've got a whole layer of rock on the bottom of the water heater. One day it cracks, and what do you think it's going to crack? It's going to actually cause a leak on the bottom of the water heater. So it's actually, a lot of clients ask me, oh, when we replace a water heater, because we're a licensed plumbing company, they go, did you fix the problem? And we're like, well, we replaced your water heater, but we didn't fix the real problem. And they go, what do you mean? It's like, well, the water heater wasn't the problem. The water was the problem. Your water's broken. If you have rock on the water, it will ruin your water heater. That's why the water heater manufacturers say flush this every year. Are you doing that? You don't need to really worry about that if you have a great quality water softener that's removing the rock off the water, because then there's nothing to settle on this. By the way, if you have electric heat, electric water heater, those coils inside the water heater break easy. So they are actually more susceptible to rock in the water than a gas-powered one. So if you've got questions on this, if you want to learn how do I stop the death of my water heater, contact me anytime, leave me a message. As you all know, I'm Drew, here to serve you.